Thank you, Johnny Olson. And let's continue right along and see if we can find another stunning challenger for you. So will you enter and sign in, please? Joyce Roell. And Miss Roell, where are you from?
Ottawa, Kansas.
All right, panel, we believe Joyce Roell's occupation to be unique for a woman. And now let's show the audience just what her line is. And I'd like to give you a lead and tell you that Joyce does perform what we call man's work. And we'll begin the questioning with Alan Alda.
Yes, man's work. Now, the reason that it's usually considered man's work, is it because it tends to be on the physical side?
Yes.
Is it something you do out of doors?
Sometimes.
Sometimes?
Mostly, I would
mostly.
Think.
Mostly. Is it something that in which you use a tool?
Yes.
Does the tool have a sharp edge?
Sometimes.
Sometimes it has a sharp edge. That's a very confusing answer.
Well, one of them might have a sharp edge.
If you use it a while, does the edge get dull? Is that?
She might use more than one tool.
I see. Do you ever use a tool in which you drive a nail?
Sometimes.
But I don't think that's primarily associated with this particular occupation, Alan. So if I may, and Joyce agrees, let me give him a no, and we'll go to Arlie.
Well, Miss Roell, is it something that you might do to the outside of a house or
yes.
a building?
Yes.
Would you be considered in any form of a construction worker?
Yes.
Are you a hard hat? No.
What?
No, they don't have those in Kansas.
Yes, they do.
Do you, are you ever off the ground and on another floor in a building?
Well, I think sometimes that she might well work above the surface of the ground in the course of her activity. Is that correct?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Would you be considered a person expert in carpentry?
No.
Two down, Soupy.
Do you ever the things that you work with, Ms. Roell? Is it metal?
No.
Three down, Sandy.
Is it important to find out the material that you work with?
Well, I would say yes, that would be helpful.
All right. You build, do you have anything to do with brick or bricklayer?
Yes.
Are you a bricklayer?
That's close enough. I think Joyce probably has the best paying job of any 16-year-old in Ottawa, Kansas, because she is an assistant bricklayer. And what does a bricklayer's assistant do?
Well, he carries the mortar and the bricks, and, he just takes care of it.
Just keeps everything supplied, uh-huh. So the bricklayer himself has all the materials in mm-hmm. hand. How heavy are the bricks that you have to carry?
Oh, sometimes I carry 40-pound bricks up the ladder. I mean, all the bricks are 40 pounds, 10 bricks.
Wow. That gets a bit tiresome, doesn't it, Joyce?
Oh, after a long day.
Well, now, I understand you work for your pop. Oh, yeah. Your dad. Does he pay you a pretty good wage?
Yeah, he pays me $1.25 an hour.
And that's a lot better than... I think Dad has a bargain. What do you think, Joyce?
Yeah.
I think so. But thank you so much. You didn't stump the panel, but we're delighted you could join us on What's My Line. Thank you. Would you say goodbye to the panel? What's My Line? We'll continue right after this word.